All right, so hello, my Facebook family. I'm here again. This is actually part two of the Bible prophecies fulfilled that led up to the president. So if you haven't seen part one, it's on my page. If you have a difficult time finding it, let me know and I will tag your name in it. But you really have to see the first one in order to understand the second one. Or whatever works for you. Either way, it's some valuable information that's detrimental to your future. Now, when I ended the part one video, I was basically talking about the prophecy of Hosea, all the prophets in the Bible, Hosea, Zechariah, Ezekiel, that led up us all the way up until President Trump. And I told you guys, with President Trump signing that peace treaty with Israel, this was the Bible prophecy fulfilled. Because God promised Israel back to, promised Jerusalem back to Israel. Israel was, Jerusalem belonged to the children of Israel, and they being so rebellious and rejected God, when God gave them these laws to follow, they lost Jerusalem. But God promised them, because he made a promise to Abraham, that he would restore it back to them. Now, this is the last thing that Trump did, well, his son-in-law actually, was declare peace in the Middle East, basically. And that peace is needed to lead us to the New World Order, because the New World Order in there, and the people who's in control of the New World Order, that's what they want us to think, that this brings peace. Now, why I said that what Trump just did is going to lead us into the New World Order is because Jerusalem is a big bulk of the New World Order. Now, before we get into the New World Order, let me explain to you guys exactly what the New World Order is, biblically. Now, the New World Order is transitioning the world from being under the Judeo-Christian world order to a satanic Luciferian world order. It moves the world from under the role of and the worship of God to Satan and Lucifer ruling and being worshipped as gods. And I mean, and all this stuff is in the Bible. It's not like this is new. This is big news. But the reason why it's so hard to believe is because it's, you know, people, you're just not going to believe that somebody just going to willfully serve Satan. And some people probably do not even realizing it, but a lot of people know what they're doing. They know what they're signing. Because the ultimate goal for Satan is that everybody worship him. He wants everybody to worship him as a god. And there are men in powerful families that Satan has gave power to. And it's that same power that Satan used to tempt Jesus in the wilderness. And see, you guys have got to stop underestimating Satan's power. So let me backtrack on Satan, because I know a lot of you guys are familiar with this in the Bible. Now, Satan in heaven, God's right-hand man. Now, if he can turn against God and get a bunch of angels to side with him, that's a wise individual. That's a wise serpent. Now, you know, and God let him think that he doing his thing. He can never overpower God. But like I said before, God gives you free will. He did the same thing with Satan. Gives you free will. But Satan is a wise individual. That's why Jesus said we have to be as wise as serpents, because you can't underestimate Satan. And Satan is a beast at what he does. One of the reasons why God has instructed us in so many scriptures to not follow the things of this world, because it is ran by Satan. And I'm about to break down how it is ran by Satan. And Satan is a beast, literally. But you can't underestimate him. Now, the New World Order is about trying to combine all the religions and making it under one religion. And what they're trying to do is kick Christianity out. And the reason why it's easy to combine all the religions, because you have to look at all the religions compared to people who serve Jesus, serve God, the Christianity, the Christian community. The Christian community are the only community that believe Jesus died for our sins. Islam, Jehovah's Witnesses, Buddhists, Judaism, what does that do? Wycon, it's a lot of religions. They don't believe in Jesus. Some religions believe Jesus was a prophet. Some believers just believe he's just a man. Some religions believe that he came as different people. But one thing they all have in common is they don't believe that Jesus died for our sins. So that's why it'd be so easy to make everybody else a one-world religion and boot out Christianity. See, that's why Jesus said in the Bible that we will be killed for his name's sake. He said this in the Bible. I mentioned the scripture in my last video. So I would suggest you guys go back and look at some of my videos. But in the Bible, he says in Matthew that we will be killed for his sake. And this is one of the reasons why, because we are in the way of the agenda of the one world religion, of the new world order. So the thing is to depopulate us so things can run smoothly. That is the purpose of the new world order. Now, how people don't seem to understand the control of Satan. Now, I know with this thing with Trump, you know, I made a post a long time ago, and I asked people to screenshot it because Trump was going to win a second term, or Trump, you know. Understand that I don't want you guys to think that I am for Trump or even God is for Trump. Trump is still just as demonic as the rest of the presidents, and he also can repent, you know, at any time. That's the beauty of God. You could just do the worst things in the world, but he will. You can repent to him, and he will save you. You just got to want to repent. Now, this thing with Trump. Trump is in office not because God think he's a great president. It's because he had the resources to fulfill the Bible prophecy. Now, with Jesus saying that, with God saying that he was going to restore Jerusalem back to Israel, Trump just fulfilled that prophecy. In addition to the people before him, not the presidents, just other people. Like I said, it's in part one of the video, so you can go back and look how everything is lined up and how precise God is. So even though that Jerusalem was restored back to Israel, this is not a good thing, but it is Bible prophecy. Now, in the Bible, it says that a third temple was going to be built in Jerusalem. That third temple is for the Antichrist. And that's who's about to show up, the Antichrist. The Antichrist is the one that's supposed to rule over the rest of these nations. That one person to rule over the new world order. Now, he also has a false prophet to prepare for the entrance of the Antichrist. Now, a lot of people say that it's the Pope, Pope Francis. And the way he's carrying on, it's easy to believe. It's very convincing. But we don't know, because the Pope now is also getting with everybody and trying to combine everybody's religion. He's doing that now, and I'm about to show you a clip of that. So, you can watch this clip.
La mayor parte de los habitantes del planeta se declaran creyentes. Esto debería provocar un diálogo entre las religiones. No debemos dejar de orar por él y colaborar con quienes piensan distinto.
Confío en Buda.
Creo en Dios.
Creo en Jesucristo.
Creo en Dios, Allah.
Muchos piensan distinto, sienten distinto, buscan a Dios o encuentran a Dios de diversa manera. En esta multitud, en este abanico de religiones, hay una sola certeza que tenemos para todos. Todos somos hijos de Dios.
We sat down and talked about the preparations for the big event. Joel revealed to me an incredible opportunity he just had to meet with Pope Francis.
I just felt very honored and very humbled. You know, seeing the Pope give the Mass to 100,000 people that day, you just see, you know, he has such a heart to help people. I love the fact that he's made the church more inclusive, not trying to make it smaller, but to try to make it larger, to take everybody in. So that just resonates with me.
The Vatican says Pope Francis is pleased with the progress made in Christian-Muslim dialogue 6 months after his trip to the United Arab Emirates. In February, the Holy Father made history by becoming the first pope to visit the Arabian Peninsula. In Abu Dhabi, he signed a joint Catholic-Muslim declaration with the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar. He is considered to be, by some Muslims, to be the highest authority in Sunni Islamic thought.
Pope Francis welcomed an interreligious group from Argentina made up of 15 Jews, 15 Muslims, and 15 Christians. They were on their way back from a pilgrimage to the Holy Land. The Pope greeted each person, some of whom he already knew from his time as Archbishop of Buenos Aires.
Y es un mensaje, ¿no? Un mensaje de que tenemos el mismo Padre en el cielo, el mismo Padre acá también, Abraham.
And one of the, what is one of the ways that Satan can get you to jump on your side? Is by providing you with riches. So before we get into that, before we get deep into the riches, let me break down this presidential election. And the reason why I'm going to break it down, because we're close to it. Now, like I said before, I posted something about Trump. I told people to screenshot this thing I put up. But I said, I see what God is doing with Trump. And I told people to screenshot it because I said he was going to win a second term. Now, I don't want you guys to take it as a way that I'm for Trump. It's because it's the Bible prophecy. Trump is being used just like Jesus used Judas. Like God chose. You think Jesus didn't know Judas was going to betray him? If he didn't pick Judas, then how would he have died for our sins? You know what I'm saying? So he had to pick Judas because he knows Judas is weak. The thing about Satan, this is why I say you can't underestimate this dude, Joe. Satan will use your weaknesses to get you to do things that he wants you to do. Now, you notice when Satan went to tempt Jesus, he didn't tempt Jesus with women. He didn't say, if you do this, I make sure you have all the women, or I make sure you have all the things. He tempted Jesus with the things that he thought was going to weaken him, like he was already hungry. You know what I mean? He done fasted 4 days, 4 nights, so he was already hungry. So you know he gonna try to get him with the hunger. You know what I mean? So that's gonna break him. He didn't tempt him with the things that he felt were weak. He tried to tempt him with things he thought that Jesus would be weakened for. And so with Judas loved money. Judas was weak. Judas was a thief. Everything was money. Even when Mary took the oil and put it on Jesus' feet and wiped his feet with her hair. What was the thing Judas said? Why didn't she take that and get the money and give it to the poor? Judas ain't bit more care about no poor. He just tried to front for Jesus. Like Jesus couldn't see right through it. You wanted that money. Because that's what he do. So why did Satan get Judas to betray him? With money. Because he won't have to work hard to break him. You know what I mean? And so that's why, you know, he got offered 30 pieces of silver with to betray Jesus. And that is why they chose him. You see what I'm saying? Now, the reason why Trump was chosen to be president is because, one, he's Satan's little agenda. Because, you know, it's not because, you know, Trump loves God, because I'm going to show you guys a clip where he admitted it. He does not believe in forgiveness, asking God for forgiveness. Because people got to understand, when you serve Satan, You serve yourself. That's what Satan does. It's about you. You consider yourself as gods, because Satan is a person that worships himself. And when you worship Satan, you're not really worshiping Satan. You are agreeing to worship yourself. So that's what makes you worship Satan, because you're agreeing to worship yourself. And that's what Trump does. He worships himself. He is, you know, he basically say he don't have to go to God for forgiveness. He can just do better. So that is why he's in office. It has nothing to do with God wanting him there. It's just that he fulfills the Bible prophecy. Now, one of the things you got to look at, and you guys got to understand something. I know you guys love y'all celebrities. You love Obama. You love all these black people. Oh, they're so successful. Don't talk down about our black successful people. These people are serving Satan. And I'm going to tell you why. Because when I told you guys that money was the root of all evil, if you look back and if you go back and look at the lives of all our famous people, and I'm talking from entertainers to music, our music modules, our athletes, the ones that are rich and famous, not all of them, you know, because we got a lot of we got a lot of C-list, D-list actors, and we got a lot of NBA players that ain't all that. You know what I mean? I'm talking about the big time people, our rich and famous people. Those are the ones that sold their souls. And a lot of times, this is what Satan does. We have people that's talented. God gives us gifts. But some of us use our gifts for evil. Like if God gives you a gift to sing, your job with that gift is to, what we're supposed to do, if we have the gift to sing, what we're supposed to do is things like that edifies people, things that glorify God because he gave you that. That's why you have some people that sing only do gospel music. That's what you're supposed to be doing. If you have a gift to create movies, your movies should help people, should edify people, should glorify God. If you have the gift to rap, if you have the gift to sing, those things are to edify God. Because our job is to get people out of this world and focus on the world that God has for us. But we don't do that. We satisfy our flesh with our talent. So now we make music where we talking about sleeping with folk, hitting it from the back, clapping, shooting folks in the head and all this other stuff. And then, you know, we making movies that's based on sex and drugs, getting high, partying all the time. Those things that's not of God. Those things are the devil. So you got to pay attention. Now, if you look back at all the celebrities that we have, if you go back and look at their life, most of those people that are doing well were once poor, either slept in that same bed with their sister or their brother, or they would share the same clothes, or they were from the projects, or they had an abusive father. Those have bad backgrounds. People, even white people, they ain't even just the blacks, but even the white people had struggles. Those ones that you have to look back, majority of them, if not all, are going to have a sob story as a background. Those are the ones that Satan uses, because we are not used to that kind of cash. And the first thing we think of when we in the projects or we growing up in this world is that we want to take our family out the hood, or we want to take our family out this lifestyle. Or we want to remove our mama from this abusive husband. We want to, you know what I mean? We want to do this. So these are the ones that Satan uses his people, his elites, that's what they're called, elites, to go to those folks and offer them these deals. Like, I know you want to be a movie film director, or I know you want to play basketball. So what we going to do, so they're going to try to take you under their wing. And what they're going to do is they're going to make you sign these deals. And that's going to offer a lot of money, and it's going to be hard to turn it down. Especially when you're poor, because most people that grow up in a project are not business savvy, and they don't understand contracts. And so those things that they hide in these contracts or hidden in plain sight, a lot of them ain't gonna pay attention to it. Even their lawyers are not gonna catch on to it. You know what I mean? Because that's the plan of Satan. He can't have you catch on to it right then, because he needs you in his world. You know what I'm saying? So he gets those people, they sign these deals, and then when they sign, it's like, oh, by the way, I need you to do this, I need you to do that, now you got to do it, because you done signed your name in blood. So if he wants you to have sex with kids or have sex with them, then you got to do it. You done signed. If you don't, you die. You see what I'm saying? Because that is how, you know, Satan is here to steal, kill, and destroy. Just because you signed, you finna get paid. You finna come up. You finna have all these movies. You're going to be the best basketball player there is because now you're signed your soul to Satan, and now you finna get that spirit, like when we get the Holy Spirit. So now, just like LeBron when he first came out, LeBron was a good basketball player, but he's even better now. You know what I mean? Like Denzel, he made it start out with his little movies. He just started blowing up. And I know you don't want to hear it, and I know a lot of you finna be upset. And personally, I really don't care. Because you need to know this. And if you don't want to hear it now, you're going to find out later. Because all this stuff is going to come out the bag. I'm trying to help you prepare for it so you won't fall into deception, which most of us have already have. Most people are so deceived. The devil has your mind so much that we can't even pull you out. You know what I mean? And that's why when you hear people talk about LeBron or people, it's so many of us truthers out here, so many pastors, it's so many different people. If you go on YouTube, it's so many different people posting the exact same thing, but people will not pay attention to it because they'll need to worship these celebrities. And that is what Satan is banking on, because his job is to kill, steal, and destroy. If a big time legend dies, the whole world is sad. Everybody posting, oh my God, Chadwick Boseman. Oh, they want to do this. And that's demonic. They want to do all these things. And they want to post, oh, we done lost a legend. We done lost a legend of Michael Jackson. Oh, we done lost Prince. Now the world is sad. And now that's like a climax for Satan. So if he can get you sad and had the whole world worshiping him, you're doing exactly what he wants you to do. Worshiping his people that he's put out in this world. That's just keeping it, getting you prepared. So now you'll already be worshiping him when he sends his son, the Antichrist. You're already in that mode. So the people that are Christians that are not worshiping and is not following things of the world, he got to get us out the way. You know what I mean? Because y'all are already serving these people. You already took your mind off Jesus and worrying about why this person died. When Kobe died, everybody getting tattoos. Ain't nobody paying attention to God. You getting tattoos with Kobe name on. That's why a lot of these celebrities die close to the Academy Awards or some type of award show. Why? So the whole world, so they can do a memory of them. They can do some type of tribute to them. And the whole world is sad. And why you sad? Satan is getting high for it. Like, yeah. And the people that serve him. That is the agenda. That is the plan. So let me take you back to Trump. When Trump even ran for president. And like I said, God allowing these things to go down because the Bible prophecy has to be fulfilled. Satan is a part of it because this is his agenda, because he wants a new world order. So let's start with Trump. When Trump was running for president, well, before he even came to run for president, if you would notice, the media created the rise of Donald Trump. You know what I mean? He went up against 17 Republicans, and he got the most attention. See, this is how you know that this is the devil's agenda, and God didn't stop it because it's a part of the prophecy. Now, and he even had conspiracy theorists like Alex Jones. Now, you know Alex Jones. If people who know about Alex Jones and listen to him or watch him, he always spoke against the government and the global and the globalists, but he promoted Trump. You know what I mean? He promoted Trump as the answer. Trump don't have what it takes to stop the New World Order. No president does. You know what I mean? But like I said, Trump fulfilled the prophecy of Israel, what his son-in-law did. That's the reason why Trump, one of the reasons why Trump was in office, because he had the resources to make peace with Israel. That's a part of the Bible prophecy. His son-in-law was a kid. He already had ties with the president of Jerusalem. So it makes sense to have Trump in there so that prophecy can be fulfilled. Hillary wasn't going to be able to do that. Neither was Obama or Bush. They didn't have what it takes because they didn't have the tie. So that's one of the reasons why Trump was in office. Now, back to what I was saying. You know, Alex Jones even promoted Trump. Now, if you notice that every word that Trump made, every word that Trump said, they constantly made sure that it was being televised and that it was sinking into our heads. You know what I mean? All you heard, but after all these things was going down, and keep in mind, you guys, you know, these celebrities and all these athletes that's preaching on Trump, call him a racist, they are stunting. They are part of the agenda. And I'm about to show you a clip about everybody helping Trump. All these rappers, even these ones that bash Trump, all of them mention Trump in their songs. If you hate Trump so much, why you like to compare your life to Trump? So let me show you this clip about all these rappers and all that mention Trump in their songs.
Yo, Ice, I did a concert in the White House, and after that, me and Donald Trump hung out.
I gotta say what's up to Digital Underground and Humpty Hump, cause he making more than Donald Trump.
Beep was going off like Donald Trump gets checks.
I got spunk, I'm well known like Donald Trump.
Pick me up and lick me up just to get a pump. Forget Black Caesar, brothers call me Black Trump.
Put my cash in my pockets, the Donald Trump.
Soon to be paid like Donald Trump.
But yo, guess who's the Black Trump?
You can boom, so I can jump to the sounds I pump. But I ain't quitting till I'm shitting on Donald Trump.
Got a business mind, so if I lose the funk, I'll still be in the house getting paid like Trump.
New Trump, brand new funk. Keep a pocket full of California skunk.
The 95 shit gon' always funk. The 96, we gon' flip the script and break them off some new Trump.
Got the room stuck, I smoke and make dope like Trump.
I ain't talk about no bullshit ass flippin' TV. I'm talking Trump type access. They coming off a gang of keys.
I'm in Trump change.
Trump change.
Nah, Trump change. Rather not Trump change.
Trump change.
I'm talking Donald Trump change. I'm talking Steve. And I'm talking, you know,
EVs. Trump change.
I'm just trying to get rich like Trump.
In hot pursuit of Donald Trump rap loop.
Niggas always expect to see us two together stable. The best couple they seen since Trump and Marla Maple.
The new Don Trump is Bill Gates. Not because his occupation, it's cause we respect his cake.
Bill Gates, Donald Trump, let me in now.
I bring your ass over the hump. We're trying to get money so we can be living like Trump.
We can talk Trump talk, real estate, stocks, and bonds.
I buy cars with straight cash, have meetings with Donald Trump.
Magnus, alcohol, and freaks, the remedy. I'm the young Donald Trump, is y'all hearing me?
Big Trump thing, making dollars, sunny holler, big bucks, man.
Doing it like Donald Trump.
I'm throwing my way like Sherman Crump. I got a hold of my state like Donald Trump.
27 cars in a 12-bedroom house. Now they call me Snoopy Trump.
I'm Donald Trump with raccoon hairdo.
I'm Donald Trump in a white tee and white ones. The conversation is money, nigga. You won't say.
What's been fired though? Bill Gates, Donald Trump, them are fire, yo.
It's been absurd money. Private bird money. That Bill Gates, Donald Trump, Bloomberg money.
Take the block, bump. Boys in the hood call me Black Donald Trump.
I'm like Trump, a nigga friend. It's only fire at night.
Resurrection of the real time to get richer than Trump.
I still does it. Weaving off a Trump budget.
Fired motherfucker, Donald Trump. Trump, nigga.
Next time you see me, I have money like Donald Trump.
Give me fame and fortune, me and Trump on golf courses. Homies on the block, say whatever they want. I don't wanna be a dealer, I wanna be a Trump.
Donald
Trump. I'm so appalled, spalding, bald, balding. Donald Trump taking dollars from y'all.
I'm getting to the money, that Donald Trump money.
First of the month. Trump to the buyers, red toupee on the coupe, you've been fired.
The Prentice, but not Trump, I'm the nigga with glocks and pumps.
Split swishers with my thumb, get money like Donald Trump.
Yo, I'm rolling in the riches, money by the digits. I got Donald Trump calling me a money wizard.
Got a kilo in the trunk, richest nigga in my hood, I'm the Donald Trump.
Take over the world when I'm on my Donald Trump shit. Look at all this money. That's some shit.
I'm trying to stuff them till I can't fit no more. I'm talking Donald Trump level.
Swear I got a lot, but I ain't got enough. Got enough. Trying to get it till I'm on my Donald Trump. Donald Trump.
We don't stop, my nigga.
Nah.
I'm like Donald Trump.
Meek Millie.
Blow it all, come back, get it again, you feel me?
Lost paper, then made it back. Like Trump being up, down, up. Play with cash.
Good looking rapper, I ain't trying to stunt. I'ma fire my blunt like Donald Trump.
Hustle, look, herself, Donald Trump, 6 mil.
They fire them shots just like I'm Donald Trump. I'm
Donald Trump. I know Donald Trump.
You can hate, don't front, my nigga. With Donald Trump in the trunks, my nigga.
You ain't got enough, better get a loan from Mr. Bill Gates. And Donald Trump.
Donald Trump. I made for a list this month. Donald Trump. I made for a list this month.
I made $1 million on that comic going Donald Trump.
Trump, yeah.
My shoelaces is iguana. Trump Towers with Donald.
No Donald Trump, Bill Gates, or Bruce Wayne. The only thing I had to my name was a few dreams.
I'm about to do a song with Bono. Pockets Trump like I just struck the lottery.
I'm talking money like I'm Donald Trump. Up like Donald Trump. Up, say swing like I'm Trump.
I'm fucked worse than Donald Trump on Lexapro.
All right, so we see that. Now, not to mention that the radio hosts, the news media, all these people, all these different news reporters, analysts, everybody was always bashing Trump. And the first thing they hollering that Trump is a racist or it's racism that got Trump in office. Now, please tell me, how is it racism that got Trump in office? Trump won't go on against anybody black. You know what I mean? Racism has always been a part of this world, and it has never stopped. It never changed. I mean, come on now. Slaves are the ones that built this country. And if you had a country built off cruelty, off abuse, you know what I mean? Off injury, off violence. What makes you think it was going away? That's the root of it. You know what I mean? That's the root of racism. You built this country off of it. You built this country off wickedness, off cruelty. So what makes you think it was going to go away? So you got the radio hosts, you got celebrities, news reporters, all these people talking about Trump was a racist. But under the same breath, they were supporting him. You know what I mean? But they, you know, they got to pretend like they don't like Trump when you know it's a part of the agenda. All our celebrities that's paid, that's getting paid to do this. They're telling them to do these things. A lot of them ain't even down with all this stuff that they're doing. A lot of these people want out. And God showed me some of the celebrities that want out that I thought most of them enjoyed it. But some of these people really want out. But once you sign your soul, either the devil, you got to give the devil your life. You know what I mean? That's why we lost so many legends. You know what I mean? And a lot of them was doing the stuff that people, like the people that, you know, died, they had all these different things about them. They did this. A lot of them really did these things. But I'm not going to get into that because that's not what I'm here to do. I ain't even, you know, y'all ain't even ready. But like I said, racism was never, had never left, and it never will. And the thing about it is the people are still shocked that racism still exists. Like, why are you even shocked if the country was built on it? It's our foundation. And so the thing about Trump, the reason why Trump got in office, because he used the same speech that Obama used. Because this is another thing. If Trump became the president of race, of racism, how did Obama make two terms and he's black, supposedly? Why is it different because of Trump? Why Trump in because of racism and Obama got in? But Obama shouldn't have got in if presidency was off racism. You know what I mean? He should have never got in, then let alone two terms? Because that's a part of the agenda. It has nothing to do with racism. And what Trump did, Trump used the same change the world speech that Obama used to get in office. Because, I mean, look at who Trump was going up against. Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton ain't black. She's just as white as she's white, just like him. But she was exposed as a huge liar, and she tried to use that same speech. It didn't work. And see, this is what you got to understand why Trump got in the office. Everybody is so ready to vote. They're using the celebrities to try to encourage us to vote. Why? Because we worship celebrities. They're using Obama more. And Obama ain't even the president no more. We see him more now than we did when he was in office. They're using him to encourage voting. Why are they using the celebrities? Because we worship them. Now, some of you guys already know. Our vote never mattered. And yet we're still trying to encourage voting. We're still trying to, oh, we need to vote. Oh, we need to vote. We need to vote. We need to vote. Our vote never mattered. How many times we keep voting for people and we can't get who we want? Obama got in because of the agenda. You know what I mean? That's how you break people. That's what gives us hope. They ain't trying to, they ain't want no black president now. They just, we ain't even gonna get on Obama. So, because like I said, y'all ain't ready. Y'all love him too much. But let me tell you something. Any of the entire KKK vote for Trump. Every racist in this world vote for Trump. It ain't gonna matter. Our vote does not select the president. And a lot of you already know this. And a lot of you know this and still trying to vote. Our vote does not select the president. The Electoral College supports that. The Electoral College picks the president. And if you guys don't understand what the Electoral College is, they are the people that we don't know. We don't know nothing about them. And they do not answer to us. So that when we vote, let me let you guys understand we vote. When we vote, our vote picks the... Let me see if I got any extra stuff before I even give y'all this. All right. Like I said, when we make our vote, our vote picks the electoral person for our district. Meaning, if it's the electoral of your district who represents the political party of your candidate. In all but two states, it's the winner takes all. So our vote votes for the electoral person of that district, of that political party. That's what our vote does. It has nothing to do with the president. And the reason why they ask us to vote, the vote, because they have an agenda. Like I said, this agenda is leading us into the New World Order. This is all about, the New World Order. That is what voting is about. When they ask you to vote, when they do the census, when they want all this to vote, all they're trying to see is what side are you choosing? They could care less about your vote. They just want to know, are you for the agenda of the New World Order or not? And if you're not, you already know what's about to go down. They want to know who is going to be in place when the Antichrist come, who they know is going to take the mark of the beast. You know what I mean? They want to know who's for the agenda and who is not. That is all our votes are for. It has nothing to do with the president. It has all to do with the Electoral College. If people pick Trump, the Electoral College is that it's for him, that gives them the go. You know what I mean? So it has nothing to do. We do not pick the president. If we don't vote, we will mess up their agenda. That is why they keep trying to push us to vote. That's why they got a commercial. That's why they got ads. Because they do not want us to mess up the agenda. And you guys are going to help them continue with the agenda. Why? Because the Bible says you're going to do it. You know what I mean? It's a lot of you guys is just weak-minded. It's a lot of people that are so mind-controlled by Satan and the people of this world that they're going to vote. And Jesus said this is going to happen. We're going to be deceived. If we don't have a lot of people that are deceived, then the Bible prophecy can't go forth. Unfortunately, so if you're not one of the ones that's falling for, you got to give God the glory. Shout right now. Give him the glory that you're not a part of that deception. Because there's a lot of us that are, and a lot of my friends, every time I see, if I post something, and I see somebody go against it, they reshare it, tell me, these people believe anything, my heart cries for them. Because these are the ones that are really not even reading the Bible, they're not even understanding the prophecy, they're not even paying attention to the things that are in plain sight. They don't believe that people are going to serve, that people serve Satan, that people will sell their souls for money, that is the root of all evil, and they're blinded by it, and you're making Satan happy. So the ones that don't make Satan happy, them the ones that are going to try to give us a hard time. That's why Jesus prepared us for it. Be ready. You know what I mean? Don't be afraid. Don't be scared, because your reward is going to be great in the end. You know what I mean? This is the part of the prophecy. You just got to be prepared for it. This is the reason why Jesus tells us to stay in the word. This is why he tells us not to do focus on things of the world. Because this world is here to kill us, to destroy us, and to steal our minds. And that's exactly what they're doing. I mean, I just gave you the meaning of governmental power. Government means control. Mental has to do with the mind. Controlling the mind equals power. So, and we're not paying, that's another thing in plain sight that people are not paying attention to. All right, so, and understand this. The United States presidency is not the highest office in the world. It's not. And this is what I mean by the love of money is the root of all evil. Now, we have at least 62 of the richest people in the world. The richest people. I'm talking about billionaires. And wait, I mean, and I'm talking about since about in the early 1900s. I mean, John D. Rockefeller Sr., he was worth four Bill Gates. He was worth three-digit billions. You know what I mean? And why do you think Bill Gates is involved in, like, the vaccine, the coronavirus vaccine? What does he have to do with anything? He ain't no president. It's because he is one of the richest men that pull the strings. And that's those 62 richest people in the world are who pull the strings, who control the president. And Donald Trump is not one of them. Donald Trump is the puppet. You know what I mean? Those are the ones that pull the strings. Those are the ones that are in charge of all the corporations. They are the ones that own the media. They are the ones that own the energy places, medical stuff, transportation, entertainment. This is their agenda, not Trump. So that's why you got to pay attention why a lot of these rich people are so involved. Why Oprah is so involved. Because they pull the strings. They are that's why I said the money, the love of money is the root of all evil. They have the money. They pull the strings. It is their agenda. These are the people that Satan have assigned to follow through with the agenda. Now, so Trump cannot fix the problems of this world. Donald Trump is used to he has been used to bring down the system. He has been used to lead us into the new world order. He's not, you know, so I don't want you guys to think that because I said that God is using Trump, God is allowing Trump to be in office so the Bible prophecy can be fulfilled. He is here to bring down, to put us in a new world order. Because you got to understand something. I'm going to show you guys a little clip about the Muslim, where they have this celebration. I forgot the name of it. That happens every year, September 19th. I want you to watch this clip because they said that this is the last celebration before the Antichrist comes. So pay attention.
Don't ever forget that this Sabbath starts what they call Rosh Hashanah, what we call the Feast of Trumpets, spoken of in Leviticus chapter 23, verses 23 through 25. This is actually the seventh month on the biblical calendar, though the Jews, Rev 2 Nines, today call it their new year. That is too much to discuss, though. It's what they are saying right now that is important. Listen to these Rev 2 Nines.
I'm going to tell you with certainty. Hashem will help us. We'll meet together after Rosh Hashanah. And remember what I'm telling you. This Rosh Hashanah is the last one without Mashiach. And it's very possible that already on this Rosh Hashanah, Mashiach is going to reveal himself. And those who know me, for more than 40 years I've been giving shurim. How many years have you heard me have, Menachem? For 10 years. Have I ever spoken about Mashiach?
This Rabbi Shalom Arush, made what they call an entirely uncharacteristic announcement. He said, on September 18th, Jews will be celebrating the last New Year without the Messiah. He is making a claim with certainty that their Messiah will be revealed after this Rosh Hashanah, and next year this time, he will be amongst them. They are claiming their Messiah is on the way, which as a believer on the opposite side, who knows the Messiah has already come, we know this figure to come is the Antichrist. To hear these people speak in such certainty that their Messiah is coming, while you see all these other events that are brewing and transpiring, it's alarming. And I believe that it should bring a sense of urgency to the world of repentance and submission to the Most High before you submit to the beast and bear his mark.
All right, so this is why I'm trying to get you guys to understand that this is an agenda. all of these celebrities that we love, all of these people that we love, I mean, they, a lot of them, they have not denied it. Like I said, Satan wants to be exposed. You know what I mean? And so that's why they do these things in plain sight, and we are ignoring it because of our love for them, and we think it's impossible for somebody like them to sell their soul to Satan. But Satan need them. They are the link to the New World Order. They are so worshipped that he know that we're going to believe everything about them, and that's going to make it easy for him to get out, to control our minds and have us leading into the New World Order. And a lot of y'all are going to be following the New World Order and into it and not even realize it. That's why the Bible says, my people perish from a lack of knowledge. If you perish from a lack of knowledge, that's on you, because the information is out there, and God he give you the information. He's telling you where it's at. He leads us to it in the word, and we refuse to follow it because of our love for the things of this world, the thing that he told us to stay away from because it's ran by Satan. That's why a lot of you guys are deceived. That's why it's so hard for you to break from your love of these celebrities. These celebrities were killed. They were blood sacrifices. The devil letting you know that he can care less if that person is a legend. He don't love us. He hates us. He will deceive us and give us all this loot and have us feeling like we on top of the world and have us playing like we the best that ever did it. You know what I mean? But in the end, he gonna take you out if you don't keep following what he do, or he just feel like you are indispensable, like he just tired, like, I don't even need you no more. He's not here to love you. But you can't see it because that money ain't nothing like being a millionaire, being there, like, forget God. Let me get this loot, because God ain't promised us this stuff. He promised that we'll have life more abundantly. He talking about health-wise and spiritual-wise. We think he talking about money. Now, he going to provide for you, because he provide for me just fine. I'm fine. I eat good. You know what I mean? I got a roof over my head. I ain't never broke. I ain't rich. You know what I mean? I'm doing what he want me to do. I'm teaching the word. I'm trying to get, you know, win souls like he want us to do. And I'm fine. He never promised that you'll be rich. Not everybody's supposed to be rich. You know what I mean? Not everybody in the Bible was rich. Solomon was holding. You know what I mean? Job was holding. You know, a lot of them, they was rich. Those are the ones that he ordained to be. You know what I mean? Solomon was rich because he didn't even ask to be rich. He asked for wisdom. That's what God asked him to. God told asked Solomon to tell me anything you want, and I will give it to you. Ask for anything, I will give it to you. Not once did he say riches. The first thing and only thing he asked for was the wisdom to be a king. And that impressed God so much that he gave him the things that he didn't ask for. That's why he had so much. You know, even he messed up, though. You know what I mean? So all this rich stuff, all these things, if people say, oh, God gave me this, God gave me that, you gotta pay attention, because Jesus said you would know them by their fruit. If you are rich and you making music where they're straight demonic, where you talking about killing folks or popping pills and getting high and sleeping with a whole bunch of people, and you tell us, I like to thank God. Do you know how silly you sound? You actually think God gonna be down with it? Oh yeah, going to make this music, talk about how you gonna slap a woman around, something that he totally against. No, the devil is blessing us with these things, blessing people with these things, and because you're doing it the way he wants you to do it. He get into the mind of your people. He is distracting you with this entertainment. You know what I mean? The news media, all these things are ran by Satan. You know what I mean? But that doesn't mean because you working for the news media or whatever you're doing that you can't change. You're going to make Satan mad. You're going to piss him off. You know what I mean? But so, you know what I mean? If they tell you to do something that you don't agree with, then don't do it. Do not sacrifice your soul to keep your job. Do not sacrifice your soul for that money. But there's so many of us that do it. That money is just lovely because, like I said, like people always say, God, take too long. You know what I mean? That's why he make us wait like that. He try to teach us patience. He try to teach us faith. You know what I mean? He try to increase our faith. But we want that money so quick. It's so like you know what? Yeah, let me sign because I need to be paid. I'm trying to get my mama up out of here. You know what I mean? And we sign for it. And then we ain't ready for what comes with it. And the thing about it is I have talked to celebrities personally. You know what I mean? That has explained this thing. So if they're saying it out their own mouth, and I'm not going to expose any of them, if they're saying it out their own mouth that this is how it goes down, and it ain't even just me talking to them personally. They have posted videos. I posted a video with Melissa Ford telling people, you got to be willing to sign your soul. She's saying this, and y'all ain't going to believe it because y'all are not taking it serious. Y'all think they talking about something else. You know what I mean? Drake has said it in his songs. Nas has said it in his songs. Jay-Z has said it in his songs. DMX has said it in an interview. All of them are saying that they're selling their souls, and a lot of them regret it. DMX, my heart goes out to him. He regretted it. You know what I mean? But you in it. You are in it. And you guys have got to wake up. This is a part of the New World Order agenda to have one religion and boot the Christianity out, because Christianity is the only religion that believe Jesus died for our sins. And why do you want to kill the Christians? Why do you want to kill the one that believes Jesus died for our sins? Because that means that Jesus is the Messiah. Satan is trying to be the Messiah. The Antichrist, that is his son. Just like he tries to mimic God. The Antichrist is his son, just like Jesus is God's son. So if we are in the way, if he can combine everybody, all the religions that don't believe in Jesus, that is power. Because then all of them are going to help boot the ones that believe Jesus died for our sins out. Because Jesus in their world is not the Messiah. The Antichrist is. You know what I mean? So let me show you this last clip. Well, I'm telling you, what they said they're going to build this third temple for the Antichrist. Check this out.
Olives with lots of tourists. Mm-hmm. And we're overlooking the Temple Mount mm-hmm. with the Golden Dome of the Rock and the Al-Aqsa Mosque.
It was believed by most also the place for the third temple where it will be built.
It's such a holy site to so many people. Why is it so controversial?
I think that's the exact purpose, because it's so holy. And all the monotheistic religions, Christian, Jews, and Muslims, all feel like this is their place of worship. And so it's very controversial of who's going to actually end up on this mount.
Do you think the three religions could share the Temple Mount?
Personally, I don't, but there is a huge movement about coexisting on the Temple Mount. And even recently, within the last 2 weeks, I know of a meeting between Christians and Muslims and Jews who all are talking about what are the possibilities and how could they establish both a temple and a mosque on the Temple Mount.
What kind of plans are being made to build a third temple?
There are actually quite a few, and depending on the group that you talk to, different architectural designs have been made. So one group is doing a design more like Herod's temple, and it would be on the Temple Mount, and I don't believe that they would have a mosque that would be there. There are other groups that are more focused on the design that's given in Ezekiel chapters 40 through 48, which is the next structure in scripture that God said to build a temple in this way. And then even some archaeological research has been done recently that would say that the Holy of Holies is not under the Dome of the Rock, which is the most common assumption, but a little bit to the north. And that's why the kind of the coexist movement is moving forward, is because it's possible that they could be right next to each other on the Temple Mount.
So what preparations are actually being made right now to build the third temple?
There are actually quite a few, and it just shows that God is giving the Jewish people kind of signs or an expectation that it's time for the soon coming Messiah. But there is a group specifically that has reestablished the Levitical priesthood. They just started a school a few months ago, and they have a registry for those who are from the Levitical line that they could come and be trained and be ready to do the service in the temple. They've also started a red heifer farm, the Temple Institute did, with an Israeli farmer. And that was, again, with ritual purity, that they need to have a red heifer that meets Jewish law and has been supervised and doesn't have any white hairs. It's completely red heifer, to be able to be burned, mixed with running water, and then used to make everybody ritually pure to be able to go into the temple.
I mean, right now, Jewish people just going on the Temple Mount can create a riot sometimes. So can you envision a scenario where they would allow the temple to be built?
A lot of the scholars that I've spoken to talk about how the building of this next temple is really going to bring peace to Israel and to bring safety from all her enemies. And so in that way, I can see that any maybe leader that would be raised up or somebody that would be able to bring the nations together, especially those who might align with Israel, that there might be some agreement that the temple could exist there and this person could be set up in the temple.
All right, so if you guys have any questions, you are free to ask. Like I said, I do not debate. If you don't believe, you don't believe. Like I said, the Bible said there's going to be a lot of people that don't believe. I mean, that's the only way that the Bible prophecy can go forth. I just pray that you are not that one. If you don't believe me, that's fine. Like I said, I give scriptures to back it up. And you guys really, really, really need to pray and ask God to reveal the truth. Read that word. Read that Bible. Get you a study Bible. Find whatever resource you need where you can get the truth. And if you listen to different people's videos, if you find people's videos that's talking about the same thing and they all are saying the exact same thing, even the Bible says if it's two witnesses, is it true? You know what I mean? So stop letting the devil deceive y'all. Stop letting him win over your minds. Because he had mine too. You know, I was a little open too. I was a little, all down for Obama. You know, these celebrities told me a little hard up. And because one of the things I was trying to do, I was trying to get into this industry. And I asked God, I have the qualifications to get representation. I have the credits. I have enough IMD credits. I've written my own film that's actually about to be a distributor. And I asked God why the doors are not opening. I'm friends with celebrities and they won't even look out for a sister. You know what I mean? Like, yo, what is the deal? But when I asked God, he did not answer me right away on why he wouldn't allow me to get into this industry. Until about a couple months ago, he answered me. And when he answered, and when he showed me all these things that went down in this industry, I was so afraid. Because my job now is to go out to the industry and minister. So I'm still gonna create my film. My films are already, Christian-based anyway. But I had to know what I was dealing with before I go out there, because I could have been one of the ones to sign something too. You know what I mean? Because, I mean, I'm one of the ones, I don't have a business background like that. They probably could have got me on one of them contracts. You know what I mean? And that's why God protected me. And he told me, he said he protected me. He been protecting me since I was young, because he knew it was going to get to this point with me. You know what I mean? So this is why he shut the doors. You know what I mean? Wouldn't allow me, because if I'm telling you, I know for a fact, and he knew that too. If they'd have came, he would have contract offered me a certain amount of money for, I would have signed just as quick. Oh, for real? A million? Let me sign right. Yeah. Oh, since you signed, I'm going to need you to start a pedophilia ring and all that stuff. Then I'm stuck. You know what I mean? Like, or you die. Or I'm going to kill somebody in your family if you don't do it. I'm stuck. So, God, I give you the glory. I thank you, Jesus, for protecting me and mine. You know, my family and all. My friends I come in contact with or wherever. I thank you, Lord, for protecting me. When God has deal with you personally like this, because you're chosen. And the Bible says many are called and a few are chosen. And he told me, I have chosen you. And I said, whatever you need me to do, I'm going to do it. You know what I mean? So this is why I'm doing these videos. You know what I mean? Because like I said before, I could have really been selfish and be like, look, I'm just about me and my family. I got to focus on me. But I love you guys too much, and I don't want to see you guys deceived by Satan. So again, get into this word, get you some Jesus, so give him your entire heart so he can keep you protected from what's about to happen. All right, God bless, and I love all of y'all.